basis for null column and row spaces of A, this matrix, given that B matrix is row equivalent to A. So we are asked to find basis for null of A, okay, column of A, and row of A. And B is row equivalent to A means this is in row echelon form. So we got a pivot here, pivot, and here is pivot. So null space requires some work, but column and row spaces, the basis can be found faster. Let me note that. So here's a pivot, the pivot, and there are none. So first column, second column, and fourth column have pivots. That means those are the pivot columns. So the corresponding first, second, and fourth, those columns make the basis for column space. Okay, so a basis for column space of A, we just write call A, is just this negative 2, 1, 3, 1. Okay, this B is used to find the location for pivot columns, and the answer will be given from A itself. Negative 2, 1, 3, 1, negative 5, 3, 11, 7, and fourth, 0, 1, 7, 5. And these vectors are in fact linearly independent. That's the meaning of basis, and they span the column space. Okay, that's easy. Now let's find the row space. Okay, basis for row space. Basis for row space of A. Now that is given from the rows. Look at the non-zero rows of B. So this one, this one, this one, these are all zeros. So the answer is given from this row echelon form of A. So row of A is just these matrices. Let me denote this by R1 vector, this one R2 vector, and I'm calling this R3 vector. Okay, then we can write horizontally the vector. So I don't want to copy, although I'm just writing R1, R2, and R3. So the non-zero rows of the echelon form gives us the row space. Okay, this one is pretty much, you can write the vectors horizontally. I'm just saving some time. For the null space, we need to do some work. For null A, we're going to solve AX equals 0. Okay, to solve this one, we use the echelon form of A, which is here. Okay, and we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is like x1, x2, x3, x4, x5. Here's a pivot. There is no pivot, means x3 is free variable. Here's a pivot. And x5 is also free variable. Okay, to solve this one, we can simply use this matrix here. And x5 is free variable. Okay, let me erase this pivot columns. So x5 is free, and from this one, because that equals 0, so negative 4x4 plus 20 equals 0. That's coming from 0. Find x4, sorry, 20x5. I missed that part. 20x5. Okay, so that is negative 4x4 equals negative 20x5. X5 is just x5 because it's free variable. Negatives cancel, 4 goes 5 times. So x4 is 5x5. That's from here, from second row, negative 2x3. Oh, no, sorry, x3 is free variable. 1x2, look at here, 1x2 minus 2x3 plus 2x4, okay, minus 7x5. That equals 0. And x3 is free variable because there is no pivot, x5 is free. So x2 equals, okay, that this implies, let me write, move these terms to the other side. So x2 equals negative 2x3 means adding 2x3 both sides, minus 2x4 plus 7x5. Okay, we know that x3 and x5 are free variables, but x4 is not. So x4 has value here. So we're going to plug that here. So 2x3 minus 2 times x4, 2 times 5x5. So negative 10x5 plus 7x5. That is 2x3. That's negative 3x5. Okay, that's x2, by the way. Now we need to determine x1 as well. Okay, so let me write here. I mean, I was supposed to write on the bottom, but looking at this one, 1x1 plus 3x2 minus 5x3. Okay, that's the case, right? 5x3, yep. Plus x4 plus 5x5 equals 0. I mean, I was supposed to write here, but I don't have, I can't see this, so I'm doing this. X3 and x5 are free variables, okay? So x1 equals subtract 3x2, so negative 3x2, add this one, subtract. Okay, that is negative 3x2. X2 is found here. 2x3 minus 3x5. 2x3 minus 3x5. Okay, that's negative 3 times. Plus 5x3. X3 is free variable. Minus x4. X4 is 5x5. Minus 5x. This should have been 5, okay? There's a typo here. It's x5. Let's combine. If we distribute, we get negative 3 times 2, negative 6x3 plus 5x3. I want to combine that as well. Negative 6 plus 5 means negative 1x3. Negative, negative, positive. 3 times 3, 9x5. Positive 9x5. Negative 5, negative 5. Negative 10x5. 9x5 minus 10 means minus 1x5. Okay, this is it. So, thus, the solution would have been x1, x2, x3, x4, x5. X1 is here, x3 minus x5. X2 is 2x3 minus 3x5. X3 is free variable. X4 is 5x5. X5 is free variable. So we have this. From this, we're gonna get the basis for null space, okay? So you got two variables, free variables, so x3 and x5. X3 here is negative 1, 2, 1, no x3. Here is x5, is negative 1, and is negative 3, and there is no x5. Here is 5, and here is 1. So I'm going to name them. This one is V1, just to save some time, V2. Okay, so basis for null A is just this vector and this vector. Okay, and the dimension is 2 because there are only two vectors. Finally.